I would like to give you this. And I have references for you in all the stuff of where this comes from.
Well, it's interesting, you know, this thing about ethnicity and race. For example, if I was filling that out, I'd probably put ethnicity maybe, you know, like Celtic, and maybe race would be Caucasian, something like that. It doesn't always fit. What about number six, class status? Do you run across that in your world? The rest of the world is a very class place. You know, I lived in Asia, sometimes in Japan, in Thailand, the Philippines, and even now like in China, you know, that there's so much structure around class. Who gets into what university, and how does that raises the quality? Whereas what I notice in the States, it may, how people move around may have to do more like with money, how they can go to live in a different house. What's this word called profession? Like when do we become a professional, and where did we get that from? Like if you were in Japan and you said, I'm a professional, what do you think they might say? Think if you went to Germany and said, it has just a completely different meaning than here. So let's say a person is a carpenter and somebody else is an accountant. So is the accountant a professional? What is the carpenter? So you don't see the word professional, you'll see the name of the profession they're in. Carpenter, accountant, psychologist, you know, you'll see that. So I put that in there as how that might fit for you culturally. So if you say to somebody, what is your profession? They may not really know what that means. But if you ask them, would you mind telling me what kind of work do you do? So it's like work meaning you go to work and you're getting paid for it, you know, that nature. I first became aware of it when I'd come back from Japan living here. And I was asked to do a talk somewhere about grief. I didn't know it had to do with children or what. And the person introduced me and said, this person is a professional. And right away I got like, now what am I supposed to do? And later it sort of, when it was said to me, I felt very kind of nervous and a little off. I thought the person would say, this person is, you know, works at the hospital and has experience working there and may be able to add to what we already know. But when it gave the word professional, well, like, does that mean I'm supposed to wear a tie, I have to wear particular clothes, my shoes have to fit, socks have to match, a particular haircut, you know, et cetera, et cetera. All of those factors, and it just kind of threw me off for a moment. So I'm just bringing this to your attention, just in consciousness of when a client comes to us from another country, or we could be from here too, that they may even just come for one time to see you because they see you as the person of knowledge. And they're looking for something from you. So the part of making that connection sort of like is really powerful. Because before they arrive, they see you as a hierarchy person, that you're very important in the society, that you have a status, and that you have a lot of knowledge, and that you can help them. So when they come to see you, and when you then ask them questions, they may go up to a certain point and then stop. And there's the kind of a stalling. So they may start lying to you just to please you. And they're thinking more now, how can I get out of here? because there's too many. So what's sometimes helpful is sort of like, you know, I'd like to ask you a few questions. Would that be okay? And could you tell me a little bit about how you like to know how to come here? And just let them talk. And leave a space, you know, that's an airspace between the finish and wait, because sometimes there is a stoppage in the story and they're sort of like taking a moment to breathe and then they're going to start again. So just wait and let the story go on. At Stanford, we have an awful lot of exchange professionals, professors who come from all over the world. And their wives, many times it's mostly men, their wives, many times, if they come, they don't have a working visa. So it creates some problems for her because she maybe have a very important job and she's here now and the only thing she can do is babysitting or house cleaning or something. And they're pressured with paying the rent and because what they're getting doesn't always match up. So when they walk in, you have to say where for them to sit, because they want to wait. They don't know. They don't want to sit in your chair. They want to sit in the chair you give them. When I first started at Stanford, for example, my boss and the assistant, I never sat in that chair. Would not do it. I would feel really uncomfortable. Would not. He had his chair, his assistant had another chair. Why? Because it's sort of so ingrained in me that is like the boss's chair. And this is the vice boss's chair. So when they walk in, they want you to keep your status. Don't break it down. Don't sort of, what I mean is, don't give up your status to the image they have of you. You say, please have a seat. You can sit on the couch or you can sit on the chair. Well, then, which chair is yours? Please tell them. Sometimes it's helpful just to put something on the chair that is yours. So you have like a book or something. I just mentioned this as sort of like that opening ceremony is so crucial in your connection. So why is that important? Because remember, many of us come here, even if the economy is good, we want to get out of the country. We look at every possible way to get out. In Ireland, things were so bad, so miserable, that we would apply to visa in New Zealand, Australia, Germany, Canada, USA, and whoever we get the visa first, we would not wait. We just, at that time, we would take the boat because it was cheaper. It cost more money to fly. And we would get to America, we'd take the first job we get. Because we didn't even know there is a second choice in another job. And we are so committed to that person who hired us, we always remember them, always. That was how we did it. Then we get paid in a check. It is not real money, it just says so many dollars and so many cents. That kind of way. So we're already drawn off. So you want to sort of bring your client in that clarity.